marathon earlier on that year. I think he just got a little bit excited on the day and ended up, of course, with Steve Kipketich taking the surprise win. And Kipsango, of course, bouncing back, and since then has had a great couple of years. And we saw the sort of shape he's in when he won London this year, that new course record. But he's going to have to do something if he's going to come up with a win here today. So Makoka's in third place, but this is the battle for fourth, fifth and sixth. And Nick McCormick doing well here. McCormick doing his best to try and hang on to Mecca, who's decided to try and pull away. Lambda Center is starting to struggle a little bit now.
You can see now they are moving out of that quieter area onto the course, into the area where the crowd seems to start to build up and get better and better as they come towards the stage. If we look out here, a lot of people have turned out and are waiting for the friends and family to arrive across the finish line, but also to watch the finish of these elite races.
So there's our leaders, and of course a bird's eye view for us, and they've got a grand view, if you like, of, or the others, I guess, going the opposite direction, are getting a great view of this race, although a fleeting one, because they pass in the other direction, and the thousands of others will be following their progress throughout the rest of the programme. Don't forget, giving Ken and Issa and Wilson Kipsang a cheer along the way, which is good to see. This, well, you've got a fear for Wilson Kipsang when they close against the finish, haven't you?
Yeah, I mean, if you look at the expressions on their faces there, I think it was really interesting in that head-on shot, the focus and the determination and intent on the face of Ken and Issa Bekele. And Wilson Kipsang is a lot more of a master. He's not really giving too much away, but I think if he is going to really make a strong move for this, it needs to be now. For me, Ken and Issa looks the far more comfortable of the two, and as though he's got this race under control.
About 600 metres to go. This is our third place athlete, Stephen Makoka from South Africa. He's safe in third place. He's a fair distance ahead of the chasing group, which, as I said, includes Nick McCormick. But still to be decided at the front, the two of them, stride for stride, the tempo picking up all the time. Akili, of course, blessed with blistering pace at the end of track races and indeed on the roads as well. And Kipsang, I'm not even sure he can even get him into top gear. I think McKeely will just gradually shift through the gears, and he's already doing that. He doesn't even really need to find his top sprinting speed. Kipsang, as good as he is, he's a marathon runner. He's a great half marathon runner as well. But with 400 metres to go, this is Ken and Issa Bekele's territory. Just has a little glance behind and knows that he can finish this at his leisure. It's not going to be a quick time today. Still recovering from the marathon. He ran in Paris in early April. Kipsang, of course, ran in London. But it's great to see Ken and Issa Bekele looking as good as this, looking as comfortable and relaxed as this. And well, his career now entering a whole new phase, if you like, and one which I think we can all look forward to. And for one, we'll be really intrigued to see whether or not he really does embrace the marathon distance. But for now, here in Manchester, it's going to be an emphatic win in the latter stages here for Ken and Issa Bekele, cheered on by this big crowd gathered here at Deansgate in the sunshine as he catches one or two of the stragglers from the women's elite race. And Ken and Issa Bekele wins the Great Manchester Run about 28-23. Wilson Kipsang, the world marathon record holder, has to settle for second place. Smiles from the two of them, a lot of